Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Wesley Methodist Church. My brothers and sisters, as we gather together this morning, we're here to celebrate the life of Doreen Frederick. Let us first begin with a word of prayer, so I ask you to please stand at this time. O Father of all mercies and God of all comfort, look down on this family during this time of sorrow and mourning. Lord, we ask you to lift them up with your loving arms. Care for them and protect them. May the loss that they have suffered be a constant reminder that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Let the memories of our dear sister Doreen continue to be a source of blessing and motivation in their lives. Lord, we ask you to bring order and reverence to all of today's proceedings. In your precious name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. Just a few housekeeping duties. My name is Patricia Adams. We have one bathroom on the entrance to the church in the foyer, and then we have the male restrooms on that side on the left, and on the right, on my right, and on the left we have the female restrooms. We are continuing to wear our masks, as we are not really rid of COVID as yet. So we ask you to try to comply. During today's viewing service, we will be supporting the family and friends of Sister Doreen as we fondly remember the impact that she has had on all our lives. We will have a few brief spoken tributes, and then we will have our praise and worship team also bring comfort. Let me begin first by sharing memories of Sister Doreen. Before I share my memories, I would like to acknowledge the presence of her family, and I would like to ask her husband of 56 long, long years to please stand and be acknowledged. Mr. John Frederick Sr., please stand. Let us acknowledge him. Thank you. Then I would like to ask all her children present to please stand now and be acknowledged as well. Please acknowledge them. Thank you. Children and grandchildren who are here presently, we ask you to stand also and be acknowledged. All other siblings, in-laws, and close friends, please stand at the same time also. Thank you. Please be seated. We as a church are praying for you. This was one of our members here, and so we share in your sorrow today. Thank you. You could be seated. Okay, now, how do I know Sister Doreen? Well, as a former guidance counselor and teacher, you meet your children, you meet your students, and you also bond with their families. So I remember several years ago, I had a young man in high school, Kishan Webster. And of course, knowing who mom is, I had to bond. So I met Roslyn then. And then they were members of our church, and you would see them seated there every Sunday. And then I met the craft lady of all crafts, Augustina. And that family for years would supply us, no cost to the church, Mother's Day and Father's Day tokens of corsages. And we always appreciated that so much. We see the joy and pleasure it brought to all of our members to be acknowledged. So both of those two ladies stand as we acknowledge you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, Sister Doreen, how did I get to know Sister Doreen? Well, you never tell an Antiguan that that's another Antiguan, because the story never ends. So I met her and I said, I'm from Antigua. And I said, where are you from? And she told me. And I said, well, I'm from the best part of Antigua. And she said, where? And I said, English Harbor. And she said, okay. And I said the same thing to Mr. Frederick. But she had a beautiful smile. She had a wonderful aura to her. Every Sunday after church, well, you know, now that the Antigua thing was settled now, every Sunday I got a better smile and a better greeting. But I missed her when she left us, and I would like to, this morning, encourage the family and to let you know, as I looked at her this morning in that casket, she looks like an angel that has gone back home to God. She looks beautiful. She has lived, she has traveled this earth, she has done her part, and so we can say, well done. We can feel a sense of sadness, yes, because we're gonna miss her, but we can say, to God be the glory, great things he has done. He lent her for us, to us for a short time, but one day we will meet her again, and that is the goodness of that story. So we pray for all of you today, and we know that God is going to bless you, and he's going to continue, even though Sunday is Mother's Day, and Augustina was just saying, what am I going to say? You're going to say, Happy Mother's Day to my mother who has gone on to glory, because she has done her job. Amen, church? Amen. Okay, so I'm going to open the floor now to two short tributes. Anyone who would like to come and pay tribute to Sister Doreen or to say something on behalf of the family, to do so now. And after these two short tributes, the praise team will render some selections for you. Thank you.
Sunlight morning, when this life is all. dwelling place there. Oh, in the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. Beautiful shore. Oh, we shall sing on that beautiful shore. The melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirits shall sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessing of rest. Oh, in the sweet by and by. Oh, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. On that beautiful shore, to a bountiful Father above, we shall offer a tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that hallow our days. Oh, in the sweet by and by, oh, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. Oh, when He calls me, I will answer. Oh, when He calls me, I will answer. When He calls me, I will answer. For my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening for my name.
Across the bridge,
there's no more sorrow.
Across the bridge, there's no more pain.
The sun will shine across the river, and we'll never be unhappy again.
Across the bridge,
there's no more sorrow.
Across the bridge,
there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and we'll never be unhappy again.
Oh, we shall have a grand time.
We shall have a grand time
up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time.
Oh,
walking with the angels. Shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. when the saints of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, amen.
Oh,
when the roll is called up yonder,
when the
glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Oh,
when the roll is called up yonder, from the dawn till setting sun, let me talk of all his wondrous love again. Then when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Oh,
when the roll is called up yonder,
the
glory,
great
things he has done. Going to see the King.
Hallelujah.
here. No more crying there. We are going to see the King.
Hallelujah.
No more crying there. We are going to see the King.
Hallelujah.
No more crying there. We are going to see the King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, we're going to see the King.
No more dying there.
No more dying there. We are going to see the King.
Hallelujah,
no more dying there. We are going to see the King.
Hallelujah,
no more dying there. We are going to see the King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, we're going to see the King.
No grave can keep our body down.
No grave can keep our body down. When the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise. No grave,
no grave,
no grave can keep our body down.
Hallelujah.
No grave can keep our body down.
Oh,
when the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise. No grave.
What a joy divine,
leaning on the everlasting arms. What a peace is mine,
what a peace is mine,
leaning on the everlasting arms.
Oh yes, sir, leaning,
leaning, safe and secure from from all alarms.
Oh yes, we are
leaning
every hour.
Leaning.
Oh yes, we are leaning,
leaning on the everlasting arms. What have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms. I have blessed peace with my Lord so near. Leaning on the everlasting arms.
Oh yes, we are leaning,
leaning
every hour.
Leaning.
Oh yes, we are safe
and secure. cure from all our loves.
Oh yes, we are leaning
every hour.
Oh yes, we are
leaning on the everlasting arms.
Oh yes, we are leaning every hour. Oh yes, we are
safe and secure from all our loves.
Oh yes, we are leaning
every
hour.
On the everlasting arms.
Brothers and sisters, was that a source of comfort? Amen. 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 Sister Doreen is happy. She's leaning on those everlasting arms. She's safe and secure from all alarms. On behalf of class number 6 and the Craft Club here at Wesley Methodist Church, we would like to express our sincere condolences to the family as well. Sister Doreen was a member of that class. And they wanted to share Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 and 4. To everything there is a season, and a time for every purpose under heaven. A time to weep, a time to mourn, but there's a time to dance. So let this passage of scripture inspire all of you today and bless you. And as I bring a close to today's viewing service before I hand it over to the funeral home, I would just like to share this tribute with the family. This is as if Sister Doreen is saying to you, it's by an unknown author. A limb has fallen from the family tree, a very important limb. She would say to you, I keep hearing a voice that says, grieve not for me, remember our best times. The laughter, the song, the family gatherings. The good life I have lived while I was strong. That's what she's saying to you today. Continue the heritage. Continue her heritage. She's counting on all of you. She says, keep smiling, and surely the sun will shine through. And she looks so beautiful in that casket. Her mind is at ease. Her soul is at rest. Remembering all that God has done for her in this life, she was truly blessed. She says to all of you, continue the traditions, all that she taught you, no matter how small they may be. Go on with your lives. Don't worry about the falls that happen in life. You will get up. She says in her own sweet way, she's going to miss all of you dearly, and you're going to miss her too. Keep up your chin. You can imagine her in that Antiguan accent. Keep up your chin. Until the day comes when you all are together again. So the peace of God be with all of you. And may he bless and continue to protect you as you go through your time of sorrow. Thank you. We now ask Turnbull Funeral Home to come forward.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, we'll have the last and final viewing. If you'd like to pay your last respects, you may do so now. Please make sure all devices on vibrate before the service starts. Thank you.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Let us prepare our hearts to worship God. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whosoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The hour is coming, and now is, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we shall carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. Our Savior, Christ Jesus, abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. I am the first and the last. I am he who was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of death and of hell. Because I live, you will live also, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain, for the first things are passed away. Let us join our voices then now as we acknowledge God's faithfulness as we sing the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Thank you.
Amen. You may be seated. Great is God's faithfulness to us, his people. Let us go to God in prayer. Most gracious God, we turn to you in the sorrow and the grief of our bereavement, praying that we might find the strength we need in your sustaining grace, so that even as we mourn the death of one whom we knew and loved, we may not be overcome by this trial, but we may hold fast, trusting in your goodness and mercy. Assure us, O Lord, our God, that death is not the end of those who trust in you. And may our hearts be so composed in the Holy Spirit that all fear and bitterness may be swallowed up in the light and peace you give to your troubled children through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty and eternal God, who by the Holy Spirit minister to us in our weakness, and by the victory of your Son, Jesus Christ, have given us the pledge of eternal life, lift us, we pray, above our present distress and sorrow, and shed the light of your grace and glory upon us, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We are met in this solemn moment, my brothers and sisters, to commend to Almighty God our sister Doreen Frederick. God sent us his Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Redeemer, and it is by his stripes we are healed, and in his name alone that we have salvation. Let me extend to you, the family, especially to you, Brother John, our sincerest condolences from the Wesley Methodist family. To you, the children, we and grandchildren and nieces and nephews and all the extended family, know that we share your loss and we will hold you in our hearts and in our prayers as you continue to adjust to this new reality, which is yours. That Sister Doreen is no longer with us in the flesh, but absent from the body, for every believer means that she is present with the Lord. May that be a comfort for you. We will continue to be here for you if you need us. Let us then recall to mind the life of our dear sister as we invite Mrs. Rosalind Frederick Webster to do the remembrance, followed by a eulogy by Mrs. Kathleen Frederick. And then we will invite Sister Lorna Freeman Woodley to minister to us in song.
Good morning, everyone, family, friends. Thank you guys for being here. I wasn't going to do this. I'm so sorry.
It's alone.
I think I'm going to lose my eyelash. Okay. All right. Mothers bring us into this world, and it's hard to imagine a life without them. They are with us when we take our first breath. They help us navigate our lives. And some of us are with them when they take their last breath. Saying goodbye to a mother is heartbreaking. It can feel like you're alone in this grief, and learning to navigate life without their physical presence can be very difficult. But if you apply what they teach you along the way, they'll be with you forever. So let me tell you about our mom, Doreen Frederick. Our mom had two nicknames, actually, Boopsy and Superwoman. If you know anyone from Antigua, as we all know, everyone from Antigua have a nickname that we think it's their actual real name until you learn differently. So, you know, for example, my father is John, but everybody knows him as Kenneth. My brother Peter is known as Fitzroy. My sister Jasmine is known as Jackie, you know, and my late uncle Alan is Joseph, and it goes on and on and on. I can only assume it was given to her at birth and stuck. Anyway, she was also known to me and my siblings as Superwoman, which was lovingly given to her behind her back, of course, by one of my sisters. I'm not going to tell them who. Okay, Jackie? Mom was always giving us chores and never seemed to get tired, hence the nickname Superwoman. She insisted that we attend Sunday school every Sunday and then church service immediately after as a child. She also insisted that we learn the Lord's Prayer, other Bible verses, and have extra curriculum activities like learning to play the piano. She paid for my sister's lessons for 8 years, even bought a piano for the house. She refused to give up on hope of having a daughter who played the piano, but ultimately, she realized her money was best spent elsewhere. Right, Kathleen?
That's right.
Okay. Mom enjoyed sending us on trips, having us participate in school activities and sports. As long as we did our chores and kept our grades up, we were good. Now, there are some of us that didn't always follow her lead and was often in trouble. It's a story for another day. Mom would eventually find out, and she did as she did most of the time, and she was not afraid. She was not afraid to reach out and touch. That's the best I could put it. She was quick to offer a disciplinary hand to those in need, knowing how to duck and run. Sean, Rod, was essential in our home as well. Mom worked hard to raise us to be proper ladies and gents. She encouraged us to do well in school, and we tried hard because we didn't want Superwoman coming into the school, okay? She was disciplined, strong, supportive, hardworking, and caring. Ready to give you her last dollar if needed. And she, yeah. She and my dad made it possible for us to be who we are, and for that, we say, thank you, Mom. We love you. Sleep well until we meet again. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Kathleen Frederick. Remembering the life of Doreen Frederick. Doreen Frederick was born on April 15, 1939, in Grace Farm, Antigua, of the British West Indies. She was the only child for Evelina Martin, who raised her daughter to be strong, independent, and a caring woman. Doreen was determined and wanted more from life than what was offered in Antigua. So she filled with ambition and dreams of a family, she moved to St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands at the age of 22. However, in order to make her journey, she left her two children, Peter and Augustine Joseph, behind until she could better provide for them in St. Thomas. On St. Thomas, she resided with Agatha Frederick, who later became her sister-in-law. While living there, she met her love, John Frederick Sr., and they were married on August the 20th, 1966. During the marriage, God blessed them with three children. I'm the oldest of the three. Kathleen Frederick, Rosalind Frederick Webster, and John Frederick, Jr. Doreen also became a mother figure to her bonus children, Anthony, Alston, Gloria, Jasmine Frederick. She ran an efficient and immaculate home. Doreen was passionate about the welfare of her family. She loved living vicariously through their adventures and always offered a listening ear. She was genuinely caring and a supportive mother. Her work experience includes Harvey's Laundromat, Butter Shoe Store, Ramesh Linens, and Rafi Salem and Family at Right Way Department Store. She worked as a salesperson and had excellent sales and bargaining techniques. She passed that down to me. Oh, wow. She retired in 1985 to devote her time and energy to her husband and her home. Doreen loved the Lord. She was a faithful and dedicated member of Wesley Methodist Church and attended the 11 o'clock a.m. service. As a mother of class number six, she continued her stewardship to her church by her unwavering financial support. She was also a member of the craft club. Doreen was baptized for a second time on April 8, 2023. She celebrated her 84th birthday on April 15, 2023. She was surrounded with love from her children and then called to her heavenly home on Wednesday, April 19, 2023. She will be sincerely missed by her husband of 56 years, John Frederick Sr. Her children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, cousin Bernard Christian, Gwendolyn Williams, and Eunette D'Souza, and her extended family and friends. May her soul rest in peace, eternal peace, Mom. We love you. We love you.
Good morning, church. To the entire family, especially Rosalind, Sarah Rosalind, we offer you and the entire family our very deepest sympathy during this very difficult time. May this musical tribute of You Raise Me Up bring a peace that passeth all understanding. Once again, please accept my deepest condolences.
When I am down and all my world's so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in silence until you come and sit a while with me.
Me again. The 23rd Psalm was very special to me as to why I wanted to do it this morning, because Mom would always, she made me learn it, and every time we had company at the house, she would say, "Roslyn, come say the 23rd Psalm." So I was her little 23rd Psalm puppet. So here goes the reading. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. This ends the reading of the word. Thank you.
Good morning, church. My name is John Frederick Jr., better known as Junie by family members. Okay, today I will be reading the Epistle, Revelations, verses 21, actually chapter 21, verses 1 through 7. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth has passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bridge, a bride adorned to her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, see, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, see, I am making all things new. Also he said, write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, it is done. I am Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift. From the spring of the water of life, these who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God. They will be my children. This is the word of the Lord.
I invite us to stand for our gospel reading. Coming to us from the gospel according to John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 6 and verse 27. Glory to you, O God. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Verse 27, peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give it as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. The Gospel of Christ. You may be seated. Revelation chapter 21, verses 5 to 7 reads, "And the one seated on the throne said, 'See, I am making all things new.' Also he said, 'Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true.' Then he said to me, 'It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children.'" Let us pray. Gracious God, in this morning hour, we invite your presence with us. May every hurting heart, Lord God, today experience the grace of comfort. May this family be bound even closer together in their love for each other and their love for you, even now as they pause today to celebrate one who kept the family together in your love. Father, we pray that the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts together will be acceptable in your sight. For you are our rock and our salvation. Amen. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. My brothers and sisters, as we gather today to remember our dear sister Doreen, who was so loved by family, friends, and members of this congregation, we can only smile even amidst our tears. Brother John, we can only imagine the loss that you feel after having this wonderful lady, the love of your life, and the person who you traveled this journey with for over 56 years. We pray that the Holy Spirit will fill that void that is now in your heart because of her passing. Children, grandchildren, extended family, it is indeed a sad time for you all. And we pray that all of the wonderful memories of Sister Doreen, whether you called her mommy, mama, grandma, whatever she was to you, Nenen, I don't know what were the different names that you gave her, but I just pray that those wonderful memories will cause you to smile even amidst your tears. As I read from the passage of the Revelation of John while he was on the island of Patmos, this passage seemed appropriate for our reflection today. John, in his vision, saw the new heaven and the new earth, so representative of the new world and the new way that Jesus came to bring to us. This new heaven and earth was different from the physical world and the earth that we experience. This vision pointed to a whole new reality, a spiritual world, something now available to all of humanity. Unlike this world in which we live and that we move in and are accustomed to, this new heaven and this new earth are eternal. And they are established for those who, through their faith, have received Jesus as Lord and Savior, and who seek to live as the people of God. The voice that accompanied the vision said, "See, the home of God is among mortals. Indeed, it pleases God, my brothers and sisters, for him to dwell in the midst of us as God's people. God does not seek or desire to be understood as a distant God, as the Bette Midler song From a Distance implies. Nor does he seek to be a God like the God of Islam, who is so high and aloof that he's not directly interested in the everyday struggles of humanity. No. This God, who spoke to John in this vision, as recorded in the book of Revelation, is a God who seeks to be intimately involved in the lives of every human being. And that is what he means when he said, he will dwell with them. Dwelling with is among the most intimate of relationships that we can experience. And it is those who live with us, those who dwell with us, are the ones who truly know the real side of us. As a Caribbean people, we say, come see me and come live with me are two very different things. So when God says that he will dwell with, he seeks to help us to understand the level of intimacy that he wants our relationship with him to have. I will be their God. Here is a flashback statement to the covenant that God made with his people all the way back from Moses to Abraham, as recorded in Jeremiah. God has always wanted us to know that we are his people. My brothers and sisters, today, I want us to know that God longs to be in this intimate relationship with us. So much so that when humanity broke their covenant, in every generation, God sent prophets and teachers to call us back to him. And then he sent his very own son, Jesus, through whose death and resurrection, we now have opportunity to live in this new covenant relationship, to be empowered and guided by the presence of this abiding God, this God who is with us in the person of the Holy Spirit, and who guides us in all truth, and who comforts us in our distress. So I say all of that to say, family members, today I want to assure you that this God who spoke to John in his vision, this God who has spoken to people in every generation, is a God who speaks to us even now. He is a God whose promises are sure. He dwelt with Sister Doreen through her health challenges. Even when she may not have remembered us, she remembered her God. And now through death, because of her faith in God and her love for Jesus, we can affirm that she is now made new. Death will be no more. She won't die again. She has already passed through that door, and now she lives with her Savior. Crying and mourning and pain will be no more. Not for her, for the first things for her have passed away. For us then who continue on this journey, I want to assure you that Sister Doreen is now reaping the rewards of her love for God and her commitment to his work and to his service.
even through this very congregation here at Wesley. So take comfort, family members. Even as you continue to adjust to life without her in the physical realm, know that the memories of her life will always be with you. Whether it is you are called upon or in a moment you might just remember that she had you as her 23rd Psalm puppet. Let's call it performer. Or whether it is you remember just as you're about to do something that you know is wrong, you feel her through the heavens reach out and touch you. Know that those memories that you have of her will be always with you. She lived a good life. She was surrounded by love to the very end. Today, may the memories of her not only cause you to think of her, but may they also point you to the God that she loved so much, so that each of you might seek for a deeper and richer relationship with that God. As you invite him through the Holy Spirit to come and abide with you, to dwell with you, so that you too can receive the comfort he offers to help you deal with this loss, but also the wisdom and guidance he offers in the Holy Spirit as you two continue on this life's journey. Until that day, when like her, the final verse of this passage will be true for you. It is from God that we have come. It is in God that we live and move and have our being, and it is to him that we will return. Verse 6 and 7 then reminds us it is done. Jesus has completed that work of reconciliation for us so that we can come to him directly. Salvation is available to everyone who will believe. Yes, Jesus is from the beginning, for he was there at creation, and he will be there to the end, whenever that end will be. And it is in the power of the Spirit that he gives us living water to quench our thirst. And it is in Jesus we who conquer will inherit all of these things. And so, my brothers and sisters, the promise is ours. I will be their God, and they will be my children. You know, when you speak about God and children, you know, it gives an additional intimacy to that relationship, even more so than they will be my people. They will be my children, children of God, all gathered here. Those of you who are joining us via the live stream, know that God's promise is for you too. Receive that invitation from God today, that you might live this life in all of the abundance that Jesus offers. And until you and I and all believers transition into the new heaven and the new earth, know that God is with us. He abides with us in the person of the Holy Spirit, and he will never leave us nor forsake us. So even as Jesus closed off our gospel reading, I offer to you the words of Jesus. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. Amen. Let us stand as we join our voices and sing our hymn, How Great Thou Art. Let us affirm our faith then in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. And I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body,
and life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated as we go to God in prayer. Let us pray. Praise be to you, O God, our Father, who created us in your own image for eternal fellowship with you. Praise and thanksgiving to you, O Christ, our Lord and our God, who have overcome the sharpness of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers, and is now seated at the right hand of God in the glory of the Father. Praise and blessing be to you, O Holy Spirit, God, our Comforter, who bear witness within us of our acceptance with the Father and have become the pledge of our eternal inheritance. All praise and glory, blessing and honor, thanksgiving and worship be to you, O blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We bless your name, Lord, for the life of Sister Doreen, whom we today lay to rest. We give you thanks for the joy and the blessing her life has brought to others, for her service to her generation according to your will, and for every happy remembrance of her life. We bless you for your mercy and goodness which have followed her all the days of her life, that now the trials of this world are over and death itself is past, receive her into your perfect kingdom and bring us with all who have lived and served you faithfully to the fullness of your eternal joy, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. I invite us to stand for the commendation. Eternal God, you have made us all, and you hate nothing that you have made, and you have given your Son for our redemption. We commend our sister Doreen to your perfect mercy and wisdom. Eternal rest grant unto her, and may light perpetual shine upon her. Amen. Let us chant together the Lord's Prayer. My brothers and sisters, right before I pronounce a benediction, let me, on behalf of the family, thank all of you for being here today to stand with them in this very challenging time. Your presence has been for them a source of comfort.
and indeed they appreciate your being here. In a few minutes, we will leave from here to make our way over to the Eastern Cemetery in Smith Bay, where we will continue this service and lay our dear sister to rest. After we are through at Smith Bay Cemetery, the family is asking you to join them at Living Word Church in the church hall for a time of sharing memories, sharing fellowship, and a bite to eat as they continue to remember, to reflect, and to give God thanks for this precious, precious lady who he blessed our lives with. So we'll make it from here, and then we will head over to the eastern side of the island. Receive now the benediction. Now the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good thing to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Our recessional hymn, Sing the Wondrous Love of Jesus, so that when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Also reminding you to bring your booklets up to the grave site so we will be able to sing the hymns that are printed in there when we get to the grave site.